Hey there, everyone. It's Michael Dougal with eXp Realty. This is your real estate market update. I'm shooting this video June 17th, 2020, and I've got all the data. First things first, we will address the average price for freehold properties, so detached, semi-detached homes and townhomes, and then we'll talk about the condo market. But if you have not yet subscribed, do consider subscribing. I post videos weekly, and if you're an ambitious real estate agent looking to connect for opportunity, then contact me. My contact information is in the description box below. And let's jump into this first chart here, which shows the average sale price specifically for detached homes in Toronto. And we can see the average price was at $1,812,000 reported June 9th, 2021, which is the highest the price has been since March 31st. On March 31st, the average price for detached homes in Toronto was $1.832 million. And you can see here, based on the distance between the yellow line and the blue line, that the prices are up quite significantly since the past year, as the blue line represents the average sale price back in 2020. Looking at this yellow line, you can see that the prices were relatively stable all the way from April 7th to May 26th. It seemed like the average price was hovering somewhere between 1.65 to 1.73, although prices really have gone up over the past couple weeks, which is a great time for sellers. If you have been, you can say, waiting to list your property due to, of course, the pandemic and all the concerns, not only are the COVID rules restrictions lifted, but we can see the average price has gone up quite significantly over the past couple weeks. It was only at $1,625,000 on May 26th. This next chart we'll take a look at is the number of listings. So not only does this measure the new listings with respect to detached homes in Toronto, but the number of active listings. And as shown, there were only 423 new listings on June 9th. Although the number of active listings is relatively high compared to the first few months of the year, there were 1,514 active listings June the 9th. So it doesn't look like there's too many sellers in the marketplace, but the great news for buyers is that you still do have quite a bit of selection as far as looking for property compared to the earlier portion of the year. Here's a very interesting stat that I came across the past week, though, is that there's a lot less number of homes that are selling over asking. Whereas if we look at this figure here, there were 78% of listings were selling over their asking price back on April 14th. But if we look at the past week and June 9th, there were only 64% of homes selling over the asking price. But this is still better than what it was last year. Last year, there were only 55% of detached Toronto homes selling over the asking price. So this market is definitely still advantageous for sellers. However, if you're a seller that has to sell their home and then buy something else, then you may be in a little bit of trouble and you may be a little bit concerned, rightfully so, because there's not a lot of homes which are actually sitting on the market, and you may see a property which you like, go ahead and sell your home, but then the property which you've liked has already been purchased by somebody else and you've lost that one, which is all the reason why you want to connect with a great real estate agent to help you through that process. And the bar graph represents all the transactions that were reported, purple being 2020, and orange being 2021. So clearly we're looking at a much more vibrant market. Look at April 7th. There were only 74 sales in 2020, whereas in 2021, there were 324. And over this last week, there were 236 sales. So we're seeing this number fluctuate, of course, based on the number of new listings at the same time. At the end of March, there were a lot of new listings which came on the market, and simultaneously, we had an increase in sales. Let's now take a look at the months of inventory. And the higher the MOI is, the better it is for buyers. And conversely, the lower number of months of inventory it is, the better the market is for sellers. On June 9th, our months of inventory was 1.18, very similar to what it was June 2nd. It was at 1.16. But if we go back to the beginning of March and the middle of March, on March 17th, it was at 0.6, which does suggest that back then it was the best time to sell your home for detached homes anyway. But now let's take a look at the condo market. First things first, looking at the average price. And the average price for condos as well has gone up. We were at $766,000. This is the highest our average price in the condo market has been. The highest prior to that was back during the week of April 14th. Our average price was $740,000. So based on this yellow line, we can see that it's pretty much been going up the past 6-7 months. As back December 2nd, the average price for condos in Toronto was only $608,000. And what the purple figure represents is the number of sales. So ever since the beginning of April, when the new lockdown did come into effect, there was a decreased number of sales that were being reported every week. But now, given that the rules have lifted, we should see an increase of the number of sales, but I am not predicting the prices to increase because while there may be more sales, we should expect to see an increase of number of listings as well. So as the number of new listings increase and the number of active listings increase, the increase in supply should offset the increase in demand. And that's what this data shows over here. As we can see, the months of inventory has been increasing. So on June 9th, yes, we had a higher average sale price. However, the months of inventory did increase, which suggests the market was better for buyers. So maybe it was such that yes, the average price increased, but that could have been because smaller units weren't coming on the market. So if it was only two bedroom homes that were coming on the market and not one bedrooms, then naturally it would be such that the average price would be increasing, which is why agents pay attention to not only the average price, but the benchmark price as well, which really gives us a clear, deep understanding of the average price. And in this next chart here, we can see the average price in 2020 based on the number on the blue line, and then in 2021 based on the number on the yellow line. So as we can see, there's a small gap, there's a small distance between the blue line and the yellow line, which suggests that the prices have increased a little bit, but in looking at the price per square foot, there's not too dramatic of a difference, especially when you're comparing the condo market to the freehold market. So hopefully you found this information informative. This is the weekly report. However, if you're looking for a monthly report where I actually compared January all through to May, then be sure to watch this video here. I think you might find this quite informative. Please do show your support by clicking subscribe below and click the bell icon so you're notified when there's new videos. And drop a comment below with your real estate predictions here in Toronto. And I will look forward to seeing you all next time.